بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. So Islam gives us some of the best manners. It teaches us to avoid speaking bad about others and looking for others' faults. And this hadith, the hadith of Abu Huraira, illustrates this for us. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من حسن الإسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه رواه الترمذي وابن ماجه بإسناد صحيح. This hadith, the hadith that was narrated by Abu Huraira رضي الله تعالى عنه, who said that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said that from the good of a person's Islam is that they leave those things which doesn't concern them. So a part of a person's faith, their iman, their Islam, their submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that they leave those things which doesn't concern them, about knowing about other people's business, about looking at other people's faults, about speaking ill about others. This is from a person's good Islam. And so let's look at what the scholars say in regarding this. So the person who has this hasana, or this husn, this khair, for example, as is illustrated, that they will receive a lot of reward for anything that relates to hasana. As we make the dua, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Oh Allah, do you know what that means? It means, Oh Allah, please give us hasana in this life as well as the next life, and save us from the fire, protect us from the fire. Because that is really, ultimately, that is the affair of the believer, is that they want good in this life and they want good in the hereafter. And the best good you can have in the hereafter is Jannatul Firdaws and being away from the hellfire. So that's what the believer is concerned about. And really, in fact, in that dua, that supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that illustrates for us the goodness in this life as well as the hereafter, and what we want to achieve as believers. We want good in this life and we want it in the next. And may Allah bless us with that. Ameen. So, a beautiful statement of Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhumah, when he was one of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, إِنَّ لِلْحَسَنَةِ نُورٍ فِي الْقَلْبِ وَضِيَاءِ فِي الْوَجْهِ وَسَاعَةِ فِي الرِّزْقِ وَمَحَبَّةِ فِي قُلُوبِ الْخَلْقِ وَقُوَّةٍ فِي الْبَدَنِ. So Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said that hasana, you know, this righteousness and this part of our iman and our goodness, that what it does is it, when we have righteousness and goodness, what does it do? Is Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that it makes light on your faith. It makes light in your heart. It makes light in your heart. Nur fil qalb. And it makes a glow or like light on your face. And it increases your wealth. So if you want to increase your wealth, doing righteous deeds. And that it also gives you love in your heart for the creation, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's creation. And it gives you strength in your body. So the person, Ahl Iman, the person of faith, the people of belief, they gain these beautiful blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they will have light on their face, light in their heart, that their wealth will be increased, and that they will have love in their heart filled for others. and that they will have strength in their body. This is the characteristic of Ahl Iman, of the mu'min, of the believer. And the Shaykh explains that Islam al-Mar'i, that when we say the Islam of a person that is mentioned in this hadith, it means that person's submitting to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and adhering to it. And Islam in and of itself is righteousness. And you can increase your righteousness with these good manners by leaving other people's affairs, meaning not getting in other people's business, and covering their faults, and protecting your own heart, and not be busying yourself with other than the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and protecting your tongue from speaking evil. And do not say good things, do not say anything unless it's good. If you don't have anything good to say, what should you do? Jazakallah khairan. Exactly. You should be silent if you have nothing good to say. And also you should protect your eyes from those things which have no ajr and no reward in it. Meaning that if you look at that which is haram, you're getting sin. If you look at that which is good, which is going to increase you, reading good books, reading the Quran, doing good deeds, and looking at the halal things, then this will increase your reward. You'll get reward from that. And also doing the other things in this life which are going to bring you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And leaving those things which don't concern you means to leave those actions and those statements. That also includes actions and statements, meaning that the things you say in your tongue, your speech, and your deeds, leaving those things which have no benefit. If something has no good in it, leave it. If something has no benefit to it, then leave it. Also, that you should be stay away from those things that are bad in this life, and that will help you for the hereafter. And that you should leave those things which will not help you to do better for Jannah, that will not help you get to Jannah. And one thing I want to mention in relation to this, because this brought to my mind a beautiful statement of the Salaf. The Salaf means the pious predecessors. It means like the Sahaba and those who followed them, the righteous early generations. They used to say, Talib al-Ilm, Talib al-Jannah, that the person who seeks the knowledge is the person who seeks paradise. So that shows us that seeking knowledge of Islam, learning about Islam, reading the Quran, memorizing the Quran, memorizing Hadith, practicing Hadith, all of these things, and practicing it, if you do it for the sake of Allah, then you'll get reward for that. And they are good deeds, and they are things that are beneficial, and they will help you stay away from the hellfire. And that's why they said, seeking the knowledge is seeking paradise. That the one who seeks knowledge is seeking paradise. So you don't say, oh, I want to be a sheikh when I get big, just because you want to be a sheikh and you want to be famous. No. If you want to be a sheikh, you want to be a sheikh because that is going to bring you closer to Allah. You're going to have more knowledge about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You're going to know the explanation of the Quran. You're going to know the explanation of the Sunnah. You're going to practice it. That's going to bring you closer to Allah. It's going to teach you how to do better deeds. That's why you want to be a sheikh. You don't want to be a sheikh to be famous and have your name mentioned and to have people speak good about you and so forth, because that can maybe take you to the hellfire, as we mentioned before in the hadith about those three people who will be judged on the day of judgment. And one of them was the scholar and the person who read the Quran very well, and he said that he did it for the sake of Allah, but in fact Allah said, no, you lied, and then he will be dragged in the hellfire. So we want to do those good deeds for who should we do them for? Jazakallah khair for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.